The Battlefield 2042 problems continue, as they are now one of the worst rated games of all time. Welcome everybody and thank you for joining me. So today we have one thing to go over, and that is Battlefield 2042. So by this point I am sure that most people know about this game and all of the problems that is going on here. The game seems to be in a completely broken state with bugs and crashes everywhere. Now the problems for Battlefield does not seem to end there, as things just keep getting worse and worse for them, as it has now been revealed that they are one of the worst rated games ever on Steam. The reviews for Battlefield 2042 is so low that they actually scored amongst the top 10, or should I say the bottom 10 worst games of all time. As per Kotaku, Battlefield 2042 officially released just 2 days ago and is now one of the worst reviewed games on Steam with over 29,000 negative reviews. Currently it sits on the 8th lowest rated game on Steam. As spotted by Forbes via the Steam 250 website, the game has now entered the top 10 worst review games on the Steam list, currently at number 8. And as more players review the game negatively, it will likely move up the list. It is still not as heated as the disaster pretending to be a video game known as eFootball 2022, but it is a very low bar to clear. Battlefield 2042 has had a rough launch, with players complaining about broken vehicles, bad hitboxes, sloppy PC performance issues with bullet registration and accuracy, and lack of features and more. While the game did receive a day one patch, Battlefield 2042 is still in a very rough shape, getting reviewed very, very poorly by thousands of players. Now, people all around just seems to be very unhappy with the game. Battlefield is a long-standing franchise, but the glory days of Battlefield 3 and 4 just seems to be very long gone. Many thought that this would be a competitor for Call of Duty Warzone and be played for years to come, but at this point that might not be the case, and I would be shocked if this game even survive until the end of the year. Fans are not just unhappy with the broken state of the game, but they are also just unhappy with all of the content that was stripped away. The game is just a former shell of itself, and the worst part of all is the fact that it will cost you over $100, which is just completely insane. And knowing EA, you probably still don't even get all of the content even if you pay for the $100+ version. I'm sure the game is even further riddled with extra microtransactions around every corner that just forces you to buy things that really should be included, not even in the battle pass, but just in the normal $60 or $70 versions. DICE used to do a really good job with these games, but now it just doesn't feel the same anymore. My only guess is that the team who used to make these games are no longer there and has been replaced, or maybe it is just a matter of being overworked and just forcing things out that is not ready. At the end of the day, I don't really know, but I do still respect the Battlefield series and I have always enjoyed playing it. I played almost every other one of these games on Origin, but there is only so long that you can ride off of previous good reputation before you start to get backlash. I don't know if EA and DICE can turn the ship around. I hope that they can, as I am sure that there are many fans who just desperately want to like this game and play this game, so I hope that they will add more content, they don't screw fans over even more with some bullshit microtransactions, and they actually fix the bugs and the issues that has been plaguing the game. But anyway, on that note, this is where I'm going to end it. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit that like button. If you would like to see more videos like this, please consider subscribing, and as always, please remember to stay safe, wash your hands, don't touch your face, and I hope to see you again soon.